Music has changed lives. And I thank God that now man can just wake up and know my job is to play music and make people happy. That's been the dream from early. 4 years ago, I wanted to quit because I felt like I wasn't getting nowhere. My name's Kenny Naharo, Kenny All-Star. Just a young man from South East London that had a dream. And I said, just trying to make that dream a reality.
My name is Mrs. Miriam Inahuru. I'm from Africa, Nigeria, Benda State. When I came to UK, I had the opportunity to go to college to study what I love to do. My husband is an airline manager back home. He was working in Sabena Airline. We decided to have a child. I get pregnant, I have Kenny. When you start secondary school, he told me one day came late, I said, why? He said, Mom, I go to radio session where they learn music. I call him again. I said, son, I really want you to become a pilot. I said, what are you reading? Now you are in secondary school. It's almost time for you to choose what you're going to do, make up your mind. I want someone to take full step of your dad. Your daddy was very good in the job as an airline manager. I don't want the legacy to just go off like that. Please, could you take the full step of daddy? He now said, Mom, if I do what you want me to do, I don't do better. I don't do very well. Or I do what I love to do, I do very well. Which one would you prefer? I said, I choose the one you will do and you do better.
If that's who you need, hey. If that's who you need, then I'll be there. So just call on me. If that's who you need, then I'll be there.
When I was in primary school, I was a social outcast. Man didn't have keys. So when everyone trading like Yu-Gi-Oh cards and Pokemon cards, I couldn't get involved in that. Even like little TV debates, like when man was watching TV or talking about a movie or whatever, I couldn't relate to that because we didn't have a TV like, at that point in my life in school. The end of year seven, that's when I started developing that love for music, because music was always the one consistency. So if man didn't have a TV at the yard, we would have like an alarm clock that had a radio, FM dial. Pirate radio became my best friend, and like that was my thing. So when I was going into school, I became more weirder, because not only now am I a social outcast, man's always got my headphones on listening to a set. Because I was such an outcast, I was getting bullied in school. Like, not as in like, oh yeah, like, give me your phone, give me your money. It was more like, well, yo, he's weird. I noticed that writing was a way of like therapy for me at that age. So like, I used to write shit down and try to rhyme it. And like, yeah, just try to spit. When I went to my first set, like Down and Way, like youth club, yeah. Everyone was spitting. When they were spitting bars, their bars were like, my jumpy. My thing came with like some deadly uni lecture.
Alhamdulillah, I'm still awake. Yeah, every time I breathe, my heart feels an ache. I'm trying to proceed with my life, me and wife on the brick. I'm trying to stay faithful, but temptation holds my fate. Run a spliff to escape, cause I'm still stuck in this Lewisham cage. Red letter bills, eviction dates, and I can't get a job cause of the colour of my race.
I was getting phased out by all the other MCs in the area. And I just, no one was checking for me, straight up. Even like my bedroom that used to spit with me, everyone would rather, like, they were on him. And I was just like the guy. And I thought I was all right for that, for my age, but whatever.
Yeah.
One time, one of my bedrooms gave me a DVD, yeah? I think it was Streets Incarcerated. And then I was like, rah. These men are going to different areas. They're filming like MCs that I used to hear about on Pirate. And then I was like, I think I need a camera. My birthday was coming up. My mum bought me an £80 Panasonic joint, yeah? Really bad quality. We're talking pixels. The pixels were low, trash, but I was like, yeah, this is hard. There was a little period where it was a bit messy at home. I was jumping out of the house. My mum's ringing me, she's getting scared and that. And then I was just out, like, you know, I used to just be about. Because I was always on the block, like, it was only made for the man them. So when the man them, they had something to say, I'd film it. I'd start shooting hood videos. Going to all these blocks and estates, one man up, nobody. I downloaded Sony Vegas, free trial, different email every month. That's how all the videos were just plastered together, slapped up on the net. I used to film a lot of content that man used to get offended by. Because remember, when you're trying to show what's going on in the streets, not everyone's going to get it and not everyone's going to like it. But I was just on this fearless attitude that, you know what, this is going to be man's hustle. Like, I'm going to start up the channel, I'm going to have my thing going on, whether people like it or not, I'm going to do it. And people used to always warn me. People always used to warn me, okay, you got to be careful, like, man from that ain't going to like it. And I was like, whatever, man. Like, this is what man's filming. I've always put on what I like, whatever. People had issues with other people, and I was just the guy that was like, yeah, fuck it, I don't care about whatever beef is going on. Man's going to put this out. And then obviously there was a few moments where I had altercations with people where I've been through the works. I remember I'm just on the way home. I got caught. You get me? I wasn't with people. It happened.
I was at the top of the hill on my bike, camera, Joshin bag. And then I see some utes coming from the top of the hill. See the utes speeding up, getting quicker. I'm speeding up. As I get down to like around the roundabout part, man's getting a bit tired. My man's just fucking still going. Buckled off the bike, tried to jump over the fence. These lot bust the second gate on bikes. One of them like clipped me with a bike and I fell literally right in the middle of where the park is near, where the playpen is. And then the rest is history. So I'm trying to kick them off, hold onto my bag, kick them off. And one of them's like, grabbed me and tried to drop me in the leg. And then,
All I remember is waking up and just seeing her face. And you see that moment, the tears coming down on that woman's eyes. It fucked me up. The last thing you want is to see your mum break down in that way. As I'm nearly dying, it's not part of the plan. It's not the British dream that she dreamt of. I see her son with stab wounds in the leg. When these moments happen, it really did make me say, you know, I think there's a deeper calling here. I wanted to still carry on the filming and combat a situation on the road to something positive. They were starting to shut down the YouTube channel. So I had like, at that time, I think I reached like 1,500 subscribers. It might not seem like a lot now, but at that point, it was, to me, it was a lot. I got some mad email. It got flagged as provocative content. It was stupid. Then they started taking one or two of my videos. The next thing you know, I signed into my account, suspended. Tried to get it back, couldn't get it back. I built up something that what I felt was crazy numbers for someone in school, going into college, trying to do something positive with themselves. I thought I was onto something. At that age, I didn't think to go at it again. So the camera just caught dust, locked it away, and I just gave up on it. Where one door closes, another one opens. And the love for DJing came back in. At this point, it's the first year of college. I'm sending bare emails. Trace FM, Radio 1, One Extra. I remember I hit up Deja Vu, because they just pay, you pay subs to go on it. But obviously I was under 18, you know, I was lying about my age. When you went to pay subs, I was like, oh, obviously it was a bit mad, like, I don't think I'm gonna have enough to run the subs. But can I do your graveyard shift? So the shift like that no one would really listen to. I took it. So Friday, obviously, I was meant to go into college, didn't go. I was trying to do that. And like, it was based in like Leighton, yeah? So at the time, I couldn't get over to Leighton. I'd have to bump a train. So I'd just be bumping train to Leighton every morning, just to try to do that shift. That's when I got back into the radio thing heavy. And I just couldn't keep up the distance of Leighton. So I started doing Represent. Applied for Represent, got called in to do a demo. I remember Gavin Douglas, it's the man, like Gavin was the guy that just put Bear Man on. The demo was shit. I remember, you got to have like a little show plan, 20 minutes what you would do. I kind of structured it as a mix show. So just me just mixing bad tunes. To be honest, they put me on, yeah? But I personally think up to now that was like more of Gavin's call. He probably just saw like potential somewhere. I was like, yeah, let's just get him on. So I jumped on Represent. I was back in the game and I had like my first regular show and I was doing Fridays 7 to 9. I think what made it different at the time was I was doing like dancehall music. Represent, I done the Bashment show. I had these connections from when I used to film. So I was still doing the Bashment things, getting all the hardest rhythms in the mix. I noticed how SoundCloud was a platform for DJs to start putting stuff up on. I was just sitting back and analysing everything. I was like, there will be a lot of people that only know me from freestyles and what I do for UK rap. But there will always be a small section of people who will always remember when I used to go universities and do Bashment sets. I started off doing £50 house parties and my rate was competitive. I used to piss other DJs off because I needed the peas in it and I had like my old laptop and again the deck that my mum bought me. I was like, let's just take them, we just break down the change and order a sound man. Someone had a link to sound system, £100 for the night. Thumping, connect everything up, man, you just do £50 a pop every time. Like around the area, we used to do the house parties and we used to show them. When I look back on my mixes, used to do 500,000 plays on SoundCloud. That's crazy. That's probably just uni people, but that's how important like that was to my come up. A man called Quavs hit me up, like proper saw a vision in me from early. He used to listen to my shows when I was doing Bashment and he said, you'll be a great interviewer. Do you want to come do some things on our channel? I was like, yeah, cool, let's do it. I interviewed Shiesty 1 week, Blade Brown another week, Fecky, these are guys that just killing it. I was getting into it. So as much as I was delivering content from them on interviews, I was like, I should start filming what I was doing. When I look back on some of the people that I've had on my radio show, I've had early freestyles from Stormzy, Jay Huss, Naira Marley, Young's Tef, Rattling. YouTube was starting to come up. Everyone wanted to see things visually. That was where the direction of the media was going. So I decided to holler at them to film freestyles for me. Midstate Madness, look, I'm doing interviews for the channel. I must be able to get like someone to come down and film. They're like, yeah, we'll do it. So I was like, I'm gonna bring through rappers. I brought them in to film for me. I had AJ Tracy come in to do the first ever Mad About Bars. So when AJ came to do it, it was just sick.
Thought that I missed the drop, but I didn't. Us man are all out here, you're hidden. My T's Real Madrid and you're Wigan. Told man already that I'll bust the 9-bar bag that to make the stack get bigger. You can't ride the beats that we've ridden. Them bars there you've got, they're all bitten. Yeah, 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 my kicks you kang. Jumped on a mic, flows too nang. Try set pace, but that never ran. Man got stomped to dash the next man. From I'm the gaffer, from I'm the boss. AJT, I'm the young Shao Kahn. What's in his pouch? Ring the alarm. Let off the scram if a man wants arms.
After that first freestyle, the man them Mixing Man was like, yo, you got something here, you know. The views weren't great when we started and we weren't watching them. We've had great freestyles in that platform. Careers that I've started to blossom through just doing a freestyle, and that was beyond the expectation. If I told you 3 years ago that I'd be sitting here speaking about Mad About Bars as one of the biggest freestyle platforms in the country, I would have laughed you straight out the door. We've had people at Shulky, great legend, come from that platform.
Me and them man, they're different. Why? Cause I want to see figures. And them man want to see bitches. I want to see numbers. I want to see digits. I want money. They want girls. Cause I'm gully. I want shells. I want to pump you with big bells. I want to work hard to hit sales.
Skindo and AM had a club hit through a freestyle on that platform.
Barely on when I step right, left, right, and then left. Would have thought his friend was a op. Cause he left his brethren for dead. Wee with a 9 or Skidda with a 10. I skidda for them.
Kick down doors, think again, you mug. Didda bow, my kick down yours. My plug gives me the loudest bud.
Abracadabra has had an iconic moment on that platform.
Man got mash up, things on things all over the place. Now you wanna chat up your mouth on Perry when your shoe was all over the place. Huh? Man best pick up that shoe. Tell my man pick up that card. When the man them hit up that fool, them man one hitch up and shot. What's your Sam he talking to? Man a real bad boy, he talking to? Man scream show when I'm walking through. Once it became your corner,
We've had so many people just make something of themselves through that platform. When I look at the numbers now and I see it growing like 30 million plus across just that platform, it makes me say, wow, that's huge, that's big. Block Diaries, it's a 17-track project. It started from a vision that I had in 2011. I always wanted to do a compilation project to go with the filming that I was doing. The past has shaped this album. Everything that I've been through in life is involved in this whole process. Man's been through hell and back to produce a project that people can enjoy and people can get amped to, people can smile to, and people can even feel emotional. This album release is gonna be probably the most important thing I've ever done in my life. This album tells a story, not just musically, but like even in tone. When I was doing freestyles on mainstream platforms, I never dumbed it down. Like I went against the grain to bring you everything raw. The way this album was recorded, this ain't no sending songs thing. Like, all the artists took time out of their schedules to come in the studio and actually sit down with me to help make these records from scratch. So even the productions, like, done on the spot just for people to kind of hear the artists in different forms. This is it, man. Like, Block Diaries is here. And this is just gonna be a storm. For my mum, she doesn't understand much about UK rap music. For her, she's just happy that I'm doing positive things. So when I told her, look, I'm gonna do a project and it's gonna have all my favorite artists on there and producers, and it's just gonna be something that's culturally relevant for a lot of people in my position, she just loved the way it sounded. But when I called her at the studio to get her a voice on the album, she was proper chuffed. I can't remember how that moment gassed her, and she would tell me how she would go into work the next day and boast to her colleagues about how she's going to be on the album. And for her, she's like, this album's going to sell 100,000 units and it's going to be the biggest thing ever. And obviously the mums are meant to say that, you know, but that was the kind of the good motivation that I got from telling her and kept me going. My mum wanted me to be a pilot and I always wanted to be in music. I think it's important for families and parents to not try and put their goals and dreams of what they want their children to be on their heads. That's pressure that you don't need at an age like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and you're going through these transitional periods. I think it's important to let us just run and just do our thing. Man stood by what I believe in and I kept on going. And a lot of young people are scared to do that because of their parents and the opinions of people that they obviously put on a pedestal. So music paid for this moment, but also my hard work and the people, my friends, my family around me that believe in me also made that happen. Music has changed lives. right now you're interviewing me in my apartment, yeah? 4 years ago, 3 years ago, I wanted to quit because I felt like I couldn't, like I wasn't getting nowhere. I thank God that now man can just wake up and know my job is to play music and make people happy through the music I play. And that's been the dream from early, so we're starting to live it now. Mad. Rap. Rap.
Stepped in, you know the rest. Always keep a couple swinging round his neck. I see them little hotties straight over there. I tell my niggas, yo, it's time to flex. And if she got potential, she can roll back with a set. I'm telling them we up. We don't waste time wondering about who up next. Walking like Bob, they're like, who is he? Corner of my eyes, he's feeling me. Wonder how I do it so fluently. They got me started, now they can't get rid of me.
No.
See how much they feeling me. Push up on them, make them feel the peace. Yeah. Call me a bad dude, they must think I'm into truancy. Brought them to the parts, made a movie scene.
Yeah. Kenny's one of the few individuals that man can say that has his soul, man. Proper love come out of his way for man.
Respect, man.
You know the thing already, man. Anytime Kenny can shout me for anything, you already know.
He started off doing his thing, and I feel like he's helped man, and man's helped him in the same basis, you know what I'm trying to say? So Kenny's good people, isn't it? You know like that.
When everyone's trying to run away from these young artists and shut their doors on developing them because it's getting the climate's getting a bit sticky, we're seeing people like Kenny still reach out to them and say, this is how you can move forward with your career. Don't, Kenny's a vanguard.
My sexy back, you know. My sexy back, you know.
Say we're out here, man, we're living.
That's what we're doing.
Come on, man. Yeah? It's about 4 p.m. We're flexing. What are you doing? At home, like a dick. You dick.
That's enough.